The ultimate goal of Nemo's Garden is to provide the option for more food for the population.
Out of the whole world we live in, only 11% is arable land, where we can effectively grow plants.
70% is covered by ocean. Why don't we try to use a part of the ocean to make more food? Nemo's Garden is an underwater lab where we are trying to experiment a new alternative agriculture.
It's a one-of-a-kind biosphere where we study the physiology of plants growing underwater.
The first biosphere was a transparent balloon made by PVC.
They were much smaller and had no sensing system, no technology. It was a very garage-like experiment. We are now to a completely different point where we have a completely different structure. We demonstrated that plants can grow in an underwater environment and they can grow successfully. We've tested more than 50 species of plants, and when we harvest them, they're enriched in their natural contents, in essential oils, in physical characteristics.
We have seen how many benefits it brings. And now we are focusing on reducing cost and optimizing process to make these technologies affordable to the whole world.
We've faced multiple challenges in the development of biospheres. First and foremost, there's no book. There's nobody who has done something like that.
Everything you build underwater needs to be so robust and resistant to a very harsh environment. Every time we want to implement any kind of technology, you need to carefully evaluate all the aspects. Then you need to wait for the perfect weather conditions, and then you need to dive. So everything we want to bring underwater takes a long time.
When Luke asked me if I wanted to get involved and help them transition from a proof of concept to a scalable solution, for me it was a no-brainer. It's important to find the right technology partner because you need to share the same vision.
When we initially started talking with Nemo's Garden, they were interested in adding automation components, robots, and harvesting tools. As we continued to have conversations and we discovered their plans for the future, we realized that we wanted to be able to help them create a design that's stronger, more efficient, and more manufacturable.
Our accelerator platform matches so well with what they want to do.
Our innovation cycle is accelerated using CMEX technology by allowing us to test the new ideas in the virtual world.
We've seen benefits in understanding the flow of water around the shapes of our biospheres. We understand points of stress on our chains and on the structure around the biosphere. We also understand how the different interactions of the evaporation and temperature and all the physical factors that come into place act on the plants, thanks to the ability of MindSphere and the digital twin to replicate our system.
For example, we used our CCM Plus to do external simulations of the design to be able to help us calculate how much drag and volume we would be getting off of different design shapes. We were able to figure out the most manufacturable design that gave us the largest grow volume while also reducing the amount of impact that we had on the environment.
If you think about it, there are so many complex laws of physics that interact with our installations that it's very hard to just imagine these. In simulation, we can foresee them and we can take them all in account at the same time. Until now, we have monitored the growth and health of our plants in a very traditional way. Machine learning and AI will boost that incredibly.
We made a specific app that is using a camera vision, is capable to see the growing part of the plant, plus in combination with all the different IoT that are coming from the biosphere.
By analyzing video images, an algorithm can understand on its own, comparing with archived data, how that plant is doing, the nutrient dispensary, and apply what is needed when it's needed much better than us humans can do, and with a fraction of the cost.
Each project, each step takes time. The Siemens technology is reducing the possibility of mistakes.
It's important to understand that digitalization isn't only for big companies. In fact, dollar for dollar, the smaller the company, the larger the impact can be.
I would summarize my experience working with Siemens as mesmerizing. I didn't even know we as human beings had the ability to do that. We plan to use Siemens technology as a service in the future. We foresee hundreds of biospheres placed around the world. We will improve the performance of every biosphere. And I think this is the future, not of this project only, but of all projects and how they will be made in the future.